Richard Fitness is one of thousands of people working for Talley's and AFFCO. But over the past year, his life has descended into a whirlwind of pain.
I'm a hard worker in general, you know. I'll push myself to do it, you know, and I just keep going and going and going and, yeah, and I just slowly worn out.
He had been working a saw at an AFFCO plant in Fielding, cutting carcasses like these. And after a life in the meatworks, his shoulder gave up.
It's just only lifts so far and stop, and it's just crunching, you know, and it still crunches. Yeah, and it just seizes up and it starts aching and aching.
When he filed an injury claim, it went straight to his employer. AFFCO is ACC accredited, meaning it's allowed to make its own decisions on claims. The company stopped his wages for nearly 4 months, as it's allowed to do while it ran an investigation. But the weight took a toll.
I lost so much weight, wondering what's going to happen, what am I going to do, because no one's believing me, my shoulders giving way.
With the pain constant, Richard and his partner Joe quickly went into debt and ran out of money for groceries.
You know, I was too scared deep because we don't know when the next time we're able to buy some food.
To be honest, it was probably many times where Richard didn't know that I went out and had a bit of a cry because I felt like I was letting him down.
Documents obtained by One News under the Official Information Act show both Talley's and AFFCO have a history of failing staff at their time of need. This letter reveals ACC had to voice concern about the company's behaviour 7 times between 2018 and 2020 over repeated issues with injury payments, showing that at times Talley's underpaid its own workers after they were hurt on the job, and that basic legal requirements were not being consistently met.
It's the same story at AFFCO. ACC ordered the company to make back payments to injured staff in 2020, describing their short-term rate of compensation as consistently inaccurate.
In response, Talley's Group, which owns both Talley's and AFFCO, claimed the company's injury program had since improved, saying the two companies had been independently audited since that letter was written, with specific focus on employee entitlements, and both now met the highest ACC standards possible, stressing that they emphatically reject any insinuation that they are deliberately underpaying employee entitlements. But Richard's case suggests history has only repeated.
Well, the list goes on, hey.
His claim was finally accepted by AFFCO in June 2021 when a doctor found osteolysis, or a melting of the bone, in his shoulder. He was back paid, but in November, Joe noticed something strange on his payslip.
She had a conversation with Richard and I said, this doesn't add up.
AFFCO had shortchanged Richard by more than $5,000. The mistake happening well after the audit in which Talley's recorded full compliance.
It's just like another knife in the back.
If we hadn't have clicked ourselves,
they'd still be underpaying.
Would it have ever actually have been corrected?
Richard is still waiting for his surgery, but is speaking out because he fears others may have been underpaid too.
Stand up.
Yeah, you have to talk. You have to speak up.
A highly profitable company underpaying its most vulnerable.
Okay, Thomas is with us now live from Christchurch. Thomas, there seems to be two issues here, the delay and then the underpayment. How did Talley's Group explain Richard being underpaid?
Look, this investigation shows that at different times over 4 consecutive years, both Talley's and AFFCO have recorded issues with injury payments. So those have popped up in 2018, 2019, 2020, and again in 2021. In the most recent example, Richard Fitness's example, they described it as a one-off accident, saying it did not represent a wider problem at the company, and calling it a regrettable miscalculation, which has since been fixed and apologised for. But as for Richard, he points out that it was only fixed because he uncovered it in the first place. And his story really shows the kind of devastation that these mistakes can have. These are people who are at their most vulnerable. They're hurting, they're in pain, they've been injured on the job, struggling to sleep at night, all those things that go with it. And here in this example, having to fight to get their proper compensation.
And where is ACC in all of this?
Look, ACC are the ones who give both Talley's and AFFCO this accreditation, and they're also responsible for auditing them. They told us that they're going to look into Richard's case, but they didn't say much more. In fact, they refused to be interviewed by us. They ignored many of our questions, and they issued just a short statement saying they've helped Talley's improve in the past and will, quote, continue working closely with them.
Tēnā koe. Thanks, Thomas.